Since an overhead crane is a substantial investment, we're going to talk about the 5 common problems with overhead cranes and how to avoid them. So I'm part of a group of overhead crane technicians that work all over the country, and they share images from their workplaces all the time. Specifically, if they see something that's crazy that should not be in service at all. Pictures of wire rope that's either frayed, shredded, or kinked clearly looks like it should be completely removed from service. And so when I ask them, what do they think the reason is? That people just aren't looking before their lift before every shift. They're just used to walking in, grabbing the controls, and making the hoist go up. Now typically, you can see frayed, kinked, broken wire rope. You can see that the diameter has narrowed quite a bit because you might have lost your core support. There are several things that you can do to identify it ahead of time, but if you're not taking the time to do your pre-lift inspection, that can put you in a very dangerous position. 2, overhead crane skew and alignment issues. Now, typically your overhead crane operator will notice these issues first. If there's loud scratching or thumping, there's a big crashing sound, they notice that it's taking more power than normal to force the crane, or it's dragging or lolling in different positions. There's different things that they can get used to that all of a sudden if they start to switch, it can cause some kind of issue. And if it does skew or have an alignment issue, that can lead to accidents, costly downtime, expensive repairs. And the best course of action is to bring in a third-party inspection company to test out your overhead crane system to make sure that it's working exactly how it should be working. Catch it ahead of time, save your money in the end. 3, excessive wear to in-truck wheels. So your wheels are going to wear out. There is no way around that. However, if you're noticing a premature wear out to your wheels, bearings, or flanges, there might be some kind of issue with skewing or tracking. Now, the best way to combat that is to bring in an inspection company to test out your crane to make sure that it's not skewing, it's tracking properly, you're having everything work as it should, so you don't have any excessive wear. So when you're looking at it, you're doing your pre-inspection shift checklist, look at the wheels and identify and log any inconsistency in the wearing down of the wheels, or you're noticing that it's happening more often than it should. 4, issues with your overhead crane electrification system. When you're messing with electricity, you gotta make sure that you have exactly who should be working on that system doing it. So if you're having issues with blown fuses, issues with your pendant control, the radio control system, or you think you're having issues with your conductors, bring in a third-party inspection company or bring in an overhead crane technician to do that work for you to make sure that you keep your employees as safe as possible. 5, bent or damaged hooks. Now, all a hook is supposed to do is hold the load in place in a specific destination in a specific position. Now, if anything happens to that hook, if it's damaged, if it's cracked, and it compromises the integrity of that hook, everybody in that warehouse is at jeopardy. So your best course of action for that is to make sure that every lift, every shift, somebody looks at that hook, all that rigging gear to make sure that it is safe and ready to make that pick. There are essentially 4 things that you can do to combat the 5 common problems with overhead cranes. Starting with 1, make sure that your overhead crane is being used exactly as the duty cycle requires. Now, this happens all the time. You might have gotten your overhead crane when you were kind of low in production and maybe business is going great and you've ramped everything up. The problem is if you're using it outside of that service class or duty cycle, you're gonna burn it out and you're gonna have more issues than you should. So to prevent that, it's common practice to have somebody come in and take a look at your overhead crane, take a look at your production, and see where you are. Make sure that you're using it correctly. It's not hard to upgrade or modernize your overhead crane. People do it all the time. But if you don't, if you're maxing out your overhead crane's abilities far past its capacity, you're gonna have a lot of downtime and a lot of costly repairs on something that you shouldn't have to have. 2, consider the environment in which your overhead crane will operate. Now, in the design process, it's easy to overlook it. You're not thinking about the environment. You're thinking about the design. You're looking at a CAD drawing or a blueprint, and that's completely understandable. But taking time to consider the operating environment, if it's on the coast and there's salty air, or if you're in a really hazardous or caustic environment, there are things that you can do to help strengthen and protect the components of the overhead crane. But if you miss that, or if you screw that up, then you might have costly repairs or downtime. So the best course of action is to bring in a lifting specialist and really lay all your cards on the table to make sure that you don't miss anything. So your overhead crane is properly designed for your environment. 3, Have your overhead crane inspected regularly. This is honestly the best form of preventative maintenance, because really, your best course of action is to have somebody come in and find that there's a problem, not have to report that there's a problem. So bringing in a third-party rigging inspection company or bringing in an overhead crane technician to run your overhead crane through its paces, see if it's doing anything wrong, checking your production, making sure it matches the capabilities of the crane, but make sure that you stay compliant as well. Number four, follow the manufacturer's recommendations for service and maintenance. If you have a car, there's probably an owner's manual in the glove box, and that tells you everything that you need to do for repairs, for maintenance, to ensure the life cycle of your car. An overhead crane system is no different, and that's why they give you those manuals, to make sure that you have a guideline of what you should do, when you should do it, how often you should do it, to make sure that you get the most out of your overhead crane. It's a costly system. Make sure that you do your part to extend the life of it. Hopefully, this video is able to help give you a better understanding of the top 5 issues with overhead cranes and the 4 things you can do to avoid them. Now, if you need some help getting started with your pre-shift inspections, we actually developed this free checklist just for you. If you click the link above, it'll take you to our free overhead crane operator pre-shift inspection checklist that'll help run them through a lot of the things that can help keep you safe and compliant. At Mazzella Companies, we have a team of highly trained inspectors and field technicians that'd be happy to help you identify any issues that you may face. If you need any help or if you have any questions, don't hesitate to contact us. Thank you for watching.